Welcome back to the Rockweb Classic training video in OpenFOAM. We are talking about the pressure boundary condition today, very short. I will give you a few hints, but I think after we are extending our project, we will get a lot of new information about the pressure boundary conditions. And I probably will also do a new video regarding pressure boundary condition. If it is available, I will just put it here that you can directly click on it. Okay, so let's start going on in our project. The last time we set up the boundary condition for the velocity, and hence we are doing as always, we are going to our project folder and just show you what we have. We're talking about the pressure boundary condition today. So the solver is looking in the zero folder and the file is called p for the pressure. So if you're going and opening this file now, it is as the last time. We first have here some comments. I always say commands. I'm sorry for that. Then we have the header description of the file, and compared to the velocity field, we have here now the volume scalar field, right? By the way, volume scalar field means it is a field that has all internal cells and including the boundary conditions or the boundary faces, if you want to name it like this. The object is P, so the object name is P within the solver, but actually this is nothing special. Okay, and then here we have the first interesting thing, because as I explained the last time, we have here kg, we have meter, we have seconds, Kelvin, ampere, volt, and I don't know, or volt, ampere, doesn't matter. So however, as you can see, we have here meter square multiplied by seconds minus to the powers minus 2, which does not correspond to Pascal. So what the heck happened here? For that you have to know about the equations we are solving here, and for incompressible solvers and incompressible assumptions, it is like there is no change in the density based on compression or expansion, and we also don't have an energy equation here, so even no temperature influence will change the density. Hence, we can put out, so the density in the equations are 1, or not 1, they are constant, it's just a number, and we can put them out of the derivatives, and then we can divide the whole equations by the density. And if you are aware of the equations, then you know that in the time derivative we have the density, in the convective term we have the density, we have the density in the viscosity term. Actually we don't have it, but we change like the dynamic viscosity into the kinetic viscosity here, and we have the pressure P, which is also divided by the density. And if you divide Pascal by the density, you end up in meter square per second square as unit. So this is actually a direct hint that we are using an incompressible solver, which means no density field is it is a constant, and we put it out, so we don't have density here. What is the advantage of doing this? So we could also say the density is constant, and however, then we had, if we do something like this and we keep the density in the equations, in this partial differential equation, each term of the derivatives, then we would need to interpolate not only the velocity field to the faces, we also would need to interpolate the density to the faces. However, even though it is a constant, it will take some computational costs, but it would be everywhere the same. So the density field on the cell center, on the surface center, will be always the same. But we had to do this calculation, this interpolation, because it is like implemented in the code like that. And therefore, we are putting the density out in order to get rid of these interpolation things. That you have to know about that. Furthermore, if you have a pressure field corresponding to this unit, so we divide everything by the density, we can get minus and negative pressure values, quantities in our simulation, because it is not the absolute pressure. We are only, so the flow field is only driven by the delta P. So in the equations, we only have delta P. And it doesn't matter if our delta P is from 1 to the powers minus 1 to the powers 5 Pascal, so atmospheric pressure, and then minus 5 Pascal, or we have 0 Pascal and minus 5 Pascal. The difference, so the delta is always the same. So be aware of this. This is sometimes important to know. And we're already having, what the fuck, 6 minutes. I'm sorry for that. But I just want to give you more general information about the pressure field and the fields we are talking here in CFD, especially in OpenFOAM. Okay, and then actually everything is the same as we had in the velocity field. We have the internal field, so we define every cell center has the pressure field, the pressure value of zero. However, again, this does not represent to an absolute pressure field. So you can also say 1 to the powers of 5, but then you would have more or less an atmospheric pressure. And if you want to have the real pressure in your system, you should divide this by, for example, 1.2, which is the density of air around. Then you would have something similar to the absolute pressure which acts in your domain. But for the calculation itself, it doesn't matter, because we are just interested in the delta P and the pressure difference. Okay, so that's why in incompressible flows in OpenFOAM, we commonly set this value to zero, and we are then calculating pressure differences. And if you are interested afterwards in the absolute value, you just multiply this by the density and by the reference pressure. And that's it. Okay. So, and then we have again the boundary field, in which we always put these our patches in. We have 3 patches here. And again, this inlet here, this is just a name. You can also name it patch inlet. However, if you do so, this should correspond to, I open it again, constant poly mesh boundary. And then this name of this boundary, which is defined in the constant poly mesh boundary, should also be named patch inlet. So actually it doesn't matter how you do that, but this inlet, if you name this patch inlet here, it does not mean any physical behavior, as I told you the last time. I checked out my video and I realized that this is like a thing I want to give you as a hint. So, and as we said, we have in the inlet, we have the velocity defined. And in the outlet, the velocity is calculated based on the mass flow or the volume flow rate, which is going through our domain. So at the outlet, we don't care about the velocity because it is an outcome of the simulation. However, you can have in mind, if you define the velocity at one patch, for example, inlet, you define the pressure at the other patch, at the outlet. So that's why we say at the outlet we have a fixed value. So all the phase center values will have zero. And all the other values from the inlet and from the walls are zero gradient. Again, this means that we just, the phase value of any phase of this patch will get the same value or is equal to the self center of the corresponding So actually that's everything. And for the pressure field, you have to know, I think it's more interesting if I'm talking about more advanced boundaries like total pressure boundary condition and so forth and so forth, and that we are going into some special boundaries here. So what I meant before was defining the velocity here and the pressure at the other patch, this does not always hold. So if you have high this is related to the characteristic of your flow, and if you have high Mach number, so the characteristic change, so that means that the information which is going through your domain is different, and therefore it is a different setup. But I'm not a guy who is dealing the fluid simulation in such flow, so I have always Mach numbers smaller 0.3, and therefore this holds mostly. You can also define like two pressure boundary conditions, so you have a pressure driven flow. I was talking with a guy on CFD online that he said the pressure driven flow is very instable with simple algorithm, which I cannot validate as I never focused such things. However, I think this is a topic of the of another talk. So we have 11 minutes. I think this is enough. And so we set up now our patch or boundary conditions for the pressure. So outlet is fixed. Everywhere it is calculated. So we get a pressure field which has zero at the outlet. And then we will actually see probably a higher pressure at the inlet because we have a pressure which is corresponding to the velocity field or maybe something like this. So, okay, that's everything for now. I hope you could get something new out of that. Actually, this is not a really big deal today. And the next time we are setting up the boundaries, the solver, and then we do our first simulation. I think this is a very straightforward way, and then we are going on in more advanced boundary conditions and maybe other solvers for that. In that terms, keep healthy, guys. Take care. Bye-bye.